Hi, I'm Dan from Essential Carpenter Tools.
And I'm Gary from GWS Precision Engineering.
And we're here today to see how the roofing square is made, step-by-step guide. So let's go inside and have a look.
Here we are inside the unit. I think it was 6 years ago, wasn't it, Gary, when I come down here?
Yep, 6 years ago.
Gary was recommended by another engineer. I turned up with my original prototype square, give it to Gary, you priced it up, and the rest is history, as they say.
It is.
What was really great, when we put the hit markings on it, I just went for it briefly with Gary, and he knew exactly what was going on the outside radius.
And we sat down with it on the CAD system, didn't we?
Yeah, that's it, and got them sorted out.
So the angle's out, got it cutting right, and away we went.
And so you got how many machines?
Seven machines, six mills and one lathe. One of the mills has got the full faxes on it and a vacuum chuck. That's the biggest machine as well.
Yeah.
It's the one that does the meter. All the others do 560 mil.
Right. Let's go and see the first stage of the square being made. Right, Gary, so this is our bare metal plate.
Yep.
And that goes in?
That goes in like this, and we clamp it down.
And that's the first operation?
That's the first operation. Nice sort of spanner tight. Check it ain't going nowhere.
Nice.
And that's it. We're ready to press the go button.
So what's this first operation doing, Gary? What's that marking out now?
We're now drilling all the holes, ready to bore them out so that we can then screw back.
I'll clamp it down.
So clamp it down properly. It's the main operation. This takes about 5 to 10 minutes.
Oh. Give us a quick rundown on the machine, Gary.
Right, it's an FV56 milling machine made by YCM. They come from Taiwan.
Right, okay.
It's got a Heidenhain control. All of our machines are Heidenhain by the lathe.
Yeah.
So that we can mix and match programs going from anyone.
All speak to each other.
Yeah, this one's got a through spindle coolant, so we can then hit things harder, drill holes quicker.
Oh, okay.
It clears the swamp out of the bottom of the holes. It's got a 10,000 RPM spindle.
Solid machine.
A little baby.
Yeah, nice.
Now we've got the holes in and the slots in. What you got to do is screw it down and take the right hand clamp off.
Right.
So we blow the air line, so you can now see where the main body is going to sit.
That's it. So the main body's there.
The angle's there.
Then we've got that one there.
And we've got the swing arm.
Yeah, you've got the swing arm.
Across there.
Across there. Okay, it's going to look. Final tightening.
Always make sure they're tight. Then undo the clamp. Then we're good to go for another 25 minutes.
Another 25 minutes.
So this is now going to engrave all of the outside.
All the top numbers on here.
All the top numbers. The British Engineering. Right. And the Essential Carpenter Tools. Yeah.
All going now.
And then we go into the cutting out. We've put all the markings on, we've roughed the outside out, cut it all out. We've now just got to take all the offcuts out so it doesn't crash when we do the finishing pass.
So it's not flying around.
Yeah, we don't want it flying around.
No.
So we just take the bits out.
That's all the offcuts there.
That's the offcuts. And then press the go button again. That runs for another 5 minutes and we're finished.
Well, then we've got the underneath to come out in a moment.
We'll set the next fixture up and we'll do the underside.
So now it's starting to begin look like a roofing square. And the next operation, Gary, is?
We've got to turn it over and we've got to take the bag out.
The sliding arm
will go up and down.
Perfect.
Yeah.
That certainly makes a nice change. I've never spent this much time here. So to see it being made and come together is really cool. To take all this back out.
All this back out, it's going to go on the fixture, we clamp it down, it chamfers the back of this, we move the clamps, and then we cut that middle out.
Lovely.
Okay. And cut the slot so it fits our angle.
Sliding arm.
Once it's back chamfered, it's going to come to us, we'll put some different screws in, take two out, and then press it over.
Right.
That's it, it's finished. The rear is done. Unscrew it. Give it a quick try. Just check, make sure it goes in. And slides.
And then that'll play round now.
The arm. That's it.
Lovely,
very nice.
Can we get the old
studs put in?
Stuck in there, press down.
Yep, and away we go.
Yep, excellent.
But now, Gary, the big old press.
Yep, we've got a press.
It's some solid old press as well, isn't it?
Yep, it's a big old fly press. We use it to push the studs in.
The stud goes in the back?
Stud goes in the back. They're clinch studs.
Yep.
So they actually grip on the outside of the hole. We put that under there. We'll whop that under there. And then... done. Nice and tight, ready to use. Nice there.
So, Gary, now you've got the studs firmly pushed in place.
Yep.
So now it's the assembly.
Right, let's go. So we'll lay it down here, pop that on there, get our little M6 nut, put one of our M6 knobs on.
And these knobs, Gary, you make these as well?
We make these on the lathe, which is next door to us. They're all made in-house. So we make the complete part is made in the UK. And there you have it. One roofing square.
Perfect. So there we have the roofing square complete. And we also have an imperial version for our American Canadian friends. And around here it's got all the rise over run markings for 12 inches. You can buy this from Essential Carpenter Tools online, it's all written here. So thanks, Gary, for inviting us over and making a great film of how it's made.
Thank you for coming.
It's been a pleasure this morning. And don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching.